everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and because I'm not really sure what to play, I'm going to be starting up a series on a game that I've played quite a bit in the past. I don't know how far I'll go with this. But the game is Path of Exile. It's a free-to-play game on Steam that is very similar to Diablo and other dungeon crawler type games like that. The audio doesn't seem too loud, but I'm still going to adjust just a little bit. Just a little bit. I shouldn't need to do that one, actually. And I think everything else I'll just be leaving where it is. I think I'll leave the rest where it is. So let's go with auto select. Okay. And time to log in. I'm going to be creating a new character. Perform temporal incursions on an ancient world treasure temple to uncover its true location. This is the default Path of Exile League. And solo self-found. This optional mode disables trade and party play for this character. You can convert it back to a regular character at any time. I think I'm gonna go with that. So we've got Templar.
You swore sinew and soul to serve God and the Order of the Templar. For years you built a life upon faith, only to smite it asunder with one sinful blow. And is that not the greatest folly of all, to lose faith when it's all you have left? You were once the chosen of God, a Templar. You are now the chosen of Rayclast, an exile.
Got Shadow.
You were born with quickness of body and sharpness of mind. How have you paid for these gifts? With innocent blood. Yours is a predatory profession. The business of butchering. You've stolen many a life to fill your purse. Now you will earn your redemption in Rayclast. Do you think you are savage enough to face the land of the damned, Marauder? We offered you truth, yet still you clasped your superstitious lies. We offered you service, yet you wasted your strength in defiance. Rayclast offers you something else. An education in true savagery.
And we've got, this is one you unlock.
A scion of perfection in mind, body, and grace. The crowning glory of our civilization, offering us hope, offering us light. But you gave us only murder and darkness. May Rayclast embrace you as we cannot, for your very presence has become too painful to bear.
That's actually a character. Unless they changed that, when I first played, you had to get to a certain point in the game to unlock the scion.
Swift and silent, you stole the bounty of others. A crow that plunders our crops. A stray dog that slaughters our sheep. Orient is a land of men, not animals. Think on that, Ranger, when Rayclast shows you how to truly live like an animal.
List.
You were born to be swift and strong. What did you do with your gifts, duelist? You squandered them on self-indulgence. Sin has led you here, your path inked in the blood of gratuitous murder. You have betrayed the Grand Arena. Now Rayclast shall be your audience and your foe.
And then there's the witch.
Why do the keen of mind seek to satiate their curiosity in darkness and depravity? Innocence is our father. Arioth is our mother. When a daughter strays from the light, she makes herself an orphan. Learn well the lessons that Rayclast will teach you, witch. It is your only hope of finding your way home.
And honestly, I think I'm gonna go with the witch because that just... Oh, you know what?
You swore sinew and soul to serve God and the order.
I think I'll go with
you. You were born
shadow.
With quickness of body and sharpness of mind. How have you paid for these gifts? With innocent blood. Yours is a predatory profession.
No, the business of butchery is I have come up with a life that nobody else is using.
Now you will earn your redemption in Rayclast.
I suppose I could just go with my channel name. Why can I not remember if it's a Y or an IE? I'll go with a Y. Oh well. Whatever. I'll go with a Y. I legitimately can't remember if it's spelled Y or IE. Whatever. You've entered the Twilight Strand.
Nothing like a brisk dip to start the day. Now where on God's ass am I?
Left click to move. Talk to non-player characters.
You and I, we're the only ones that made it to shore. Alive, anyway. Looks like you found something you can defend yourself with. Good. This place is crawling with criminals. There's smoke rising just east of here. Could be worth checking if there's...
Is it possible to murder someone who's already dead?
Press I to view your inventory. No, I think I'm actually going to increase the volume. Because that seems like it's probably a bit too quiet. Skill gems grant powerful skills when they are socketed in your weapons and armor. To socket the skill gem, first click it. To pick it up, then click on the socket on your weapon that has the same color. The skill is now equipped on your skill bar and can be used with right click. Press I to close your inventory. So I got Viper Strike. Hits the enemy, adding some of your physical damage as chaos damage and applying poison. Requires a claw, dagger, or sword. 25% of physical damage converted to chaos damage. Base duration is 4 seconds. Deals 115% of base damage. 60% chance to poison on hit. Okay. Skills use mana. If you run out of mana, your skills won't work. I have played this somewhat recently, but not since this most recent update. There's been an update since the last time I played it. There's been at least one update since the last time I played. Now, I don't know if I'll play through the entire game because there seems to be quite a bit to it. Depends on how much I enjoy playing it, I guess. And we've got potions here that we use with the number keys that refill as we kill enemies. Large chest. Lesser poison support. Supported skills have a 40% chance to poison on hit. Supported skills have 1 to 2 added chaos damage. That will work with the thing I've got right here. The connection there. There's a connection between this skill slot and this slot. Or this socket and this socket. And that's where you use this. You put this into this one and it will support the connected gem. Or the connected skill. It's actually a rather... This game is actually rather cool, honestly. I don't think I need another mana flask. This game actually is much more complex than the Diablo games, like creating a character class and stuff. You choose your class, but your skills and everything, it's just, there's so much to choose from. You can create... You can create pretty diverse characters. Increased stun and block recovery, reflects 4 physical damage to melee attackers. Okay. But yeah, what I mean by that is... How the hell do I open that again? It's S? No. Oh, well, I'll figure it out. And it won't be too long before I figure out how.
It's nice not being dead yet.
Gain a skill point when you leveled up. Click here or press P to use your skill point. P, okay. Yeah, this is what I was saying. This is your skill points tree. You can do so much shit with this. I mean, granted, we start here with this class. I believe this is where the witch starts. Can't remember which one it was that started there. I mean, each of these things is a starting point for a different class, but you can use skill points to work your way up and into these, so I could technically work my way up into here to increase my mana and my energy shield and intelligence and stuff over time. But damage and energy shield versus physical and chaos damage and life. I think I'll go for the damage and energy shield and apply the points. Now, energy shield is basically it's some armor or some additional life, I guess you could say. That gets drained before your health, I believe. If I remember correctly. It's been quite a while since I played this, but I played it a few months ago, the last time, but it's been long enough that I don't really remember a whole lot about how things work at the moment. I will after I get farther into it and start to, kill Hillock. This guy's... Our first kind of a boss, I guess. Not really. Enemy of the key. You have killed Hillock, the zombie attacking the town, and leveled up. Open the passive skill screen and spend a passive skill point to upgrade your character. I leveled up from that. No, I didn't. You lie to me. But now we just picked up some more items. Glass shank. This is another glass shank. Rusted hatchet 6 to 11, 6 to 10. The reason I switched that is because these ones are linked and the other one wasn't. Something about this game is it requires a constant internet connection. Kind of like Diablo 3 does, I guess. And I've seen so many people say that this game is what Diablo 3 should have been, but honestly, I disagree. I mean, I see that so often where people will say that this is what... Okay, I'm gonna have to bring my graphics down a little bit. Texture quality. smoother now. Letters of Exile.
Kaffar of Beecham, you have transgressed against your god and your fellow man. You have been a willing vessel for the following sins. Unlawful avarice, one count of possessing stolen goods. Civil envy, one count of resisting Templar authority. God has charged me with your redemption. You are hereby exiled to Rayclast, where it is hoped you shall come to repent your sins and make your peace with your beloved father. Joy of Kimby, you have transgressed against your god and your fellow man. You have been a willing vessel for the following sins. Civil envy, one count of harboring a sentenced exile. God has charged me with your redemption. You are hereby exiled to Rayclast, where it is hoped you shall come to repent your sins and make your peace with your beloved father.
So we've got waypoints in here. They're pretty much the same as they were in the Diablo games. Got my stash here. Then there's microtransactions in the game, of course, because it's a free-to-play game. They've got microtransactions. You can control-click to instantly transfer items between your stash and inventory. Hold Alt to see more information about items that you hover the mouse over.
I saw what you did to Hillock out there, Shadow. Your murderous art is the reason you're here, in exile, and it'll be the one thing that sees you through to another dawn. I'm Nessa. And I suppose I should thank you for ridding us of that putrid giant. Back in Aureoth, I feared your kind, condemned you from afar. In Rayclast, I don't have that luxury. Lion-Eye's watch isn't much, but it's ours. We could use you here, while you live. But should you wish to venture out, do just one thing for me. Out on the coast, amongst the wrecks, there must be a ship's medicine chest. I have many to care for, and there's only so much I can do with herbs and seawater. Be well.
A sodden shadow staggered from the surf and surveyed the somber strand. That's the first line of the poem I'm writing about you, Redside. Easy, you could poison a bloke with a look like that. The name's Beston, captain of the good ship Merry Gown. Unless my Merry Gown is gone, my crew is gone. But my wits remain after a fashion. There's an island, a hop, skip, and a wade offshore of the terraces. That's where my Merry Gull ran aground. Watch the locals spit roast the ship's doctor, but his medicine chest might still be there, amongst the splinters and bones. It'd have everything Nessa might need. Dr. Shaky Hands Opton was lousy with a scalpel and even worse with a saw, but he knew his apothecary. Explains the shaky hands, if you ask me.
Fine work with Hillock. Where'd you learn to fight like that? No, forget I asked. We exiles have no history. Dominus took it from us when he had his blackguards dump us in the water out there. Here, got something for you. Should help you kill a few more of those undead bastards. No, don't bother thanking me. The way I figure it, the longer we fighters live, the longer everyone lives.
So I get to choose a skill. Freezing Pulse, Icy Projectile, which has a chance to freeze enemies. It passes through. The projectile fades quickly, reducing damage and freezing chance until it dissipates. 7 to 11 damage. Explosive Trap. There's a trap that creates a large explosion when triggered, dealing spell damage in an area. A number of smaller explosions occur around this area in quick succession. 5 to 7 damage, 50% physical damage converted to fire. 4 seconds causes 4 smaller explosions. Lightning Tendrils. Well, you channel the skill, it releases pulses of electrical energy, dealing lightning damage in a semi-circular area in front of you. 1 to 3 lightning damage. Releases stronger pulse every 4 pulses. Stronger pulses deal 50% more damage with hits and ailments. Ethereal Knives. fires an arc of knives in front of the caster, which deals physical damage. 6-9 damage, fires 9 additional projectiles. And Frost Blades. Attack an enemy with increased range, releasing icy blades from the targeted enemy, which fly at other enemies. It requires a melee weapon. 60% of physical damage converted to cold damage, fires 4 additional projectiles, plus 18 to melee weapon range. I like the sound of that. So yeah, our currency is scroll fragments, and when you get 5, you get another scroll of wisdom, and you use those for purchasing other things. Or for identifying unidentified items.
Farewell.
The currency in this game is really weird.
Hello. God hasn't abandoned us.
Okay. I suppose I can head out here.
The furnace down at the slaughterhouse. Yes, that's what this place smells like.
Okay, yeah, I like that skill. Frostblade's gem is now ready to level up. There we go. Shift to attack without moving. And poison support level. It's been quite a while since I actually, not quite a while, but as I mentioned, it's been at least a few months since I played this. And apparently we've got a new challenge league going since the last time as well. Challenge leagues are... they're similar to the seasons in Diablo 3, I guess. They change every so often. I'm not sure how frequently.
I'm impressed by how much this place wants me dead.
Okay. not gonna read all of these things, because that's just way too much reading. Skill point, apparently. Okay. I think I'm going to be using this other one more than I use that Viper Strike. Okay, so what the hell am I doing now? This is honestly a pretty entertaining game once you get farther into it. I mean, of course, like most games, it starts out a bit slow. Most of this type of game, anyways. It starts out a bit slow, but once you get into it more, it is pretty fun. Change your skill things around pretty frequently, so that's helpful. You can just switch them around whenever you feel like it, really. Thank you. looks like I just gotta head back to town then. I don't want to use the portal scroll because those are, at least for the first little while of the game, those are pretty difficult to come by. I mean, later on it gets a bit easier, but for the time being they can be pretty difficult to come by. And when you're close enough to just head back like this, I mean, why not?
What little help I can offer is yours. While we live, we are blessed.
So, let's see if I can get another weapon from this guy.
Greetings!
Or, no, anything, maybe. Boots. Certainly use some boots.
Stay sharp out there.
A belt.
Hello.
I don't need hands or anything just yet.
While we live, we are blessed.
Let's go ahead and head back out here. One thing that could make this difficult to, I might as well just clear that little section down there, could make this difficult to do videos on is the frequency of the waypoints and the fact that the places will repopulate with enemies if you haven't been in them for like 15 minutes or something like that. So sometimes you end up having to fight your way through an area again, which is rather frustrating at times. The blacksmith's whetstones were used to increase the quality of your weapons. If I remember correctly. expecting more enemies. I don't know why. Hopefully the waypoint isn't far, because I think, yeah, it's right there.
Khan's canoe struck this sand with the force of destiny. At his beck, the greatest war host in Kardui history tamed the wild sea, their canoes coupling with the land one by one. Lion-eyed gemlings met us with shining metal and bold words. Hyri's arrows withered their pride, Khan's axes silenced their despair. Marseille's Lion Eye fought bravely to the last. Calm honored him with a place on his belt. Calm has shown Rayclast our Kardui strength. Calm will teach Rayclast the Kardui way.
So that's a bit of lore. That's where we go for the medicine chest, but I'm not going to be going in there in this episode because I'm already looking at, what, 45 minutes here, 43 minutes, but still.
Hello. God hasn't abandoned us.
Upgrades a normal item to a rare item. No. Why the hell not? Nice. Plus 9 to strength, 7% increased armor, 4 maximum life, 2 life regenerated per second, and 6% increased stun and block. Not bad. And yeah, improves the quality of the weapon. I'm gonna head back out and grab those items. There's also a way, I can't remember how you do it, but you can force a new instance of an area. Like if I was to go into that island, you hold down, might have been control and then click on the entryway to it. I don't remember what it was exactly. I'm gonna try that. But yeah, I believe. Was it just holding control and doing it? Yes. Instances stay open for 8 to 15 minutes. So yeah, you can force a new instance. Which will cause it to be, you'd have to clear the area again. The map is reset and there's enemies and everything in there again.
Mm-hmm. Take care.
But I believe I'm gonna end this episode here. And I will pick it up in the next one. So that's it for this episode. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.